Every little breeze seems to whisper Louise. Bells and Z-twins seem to tweet to Louise. Each little rose tells me it knows I love you, love you. Every little beat that I feel in my heart seems to repeat what I felt from the start. Each little sigh tells me that I adore you, yeah, yeah. Just to see and hear you, joy I never knew. But to be so near you thrills me through and through. Anyone can see why I wanted your kiss. It had to be, but the wonder is this. Can it be true someone like you could love Louise?
Bonjour mes amis, bienvenue à Paris. My name is Pierre Vaurien, and I have lived here in La Ville de Lumière, the City of Light, all my life. I know Paris like I know my Chateauneuf du Pape. So I welcome you to Paris, city of love, sometimes too much love, where even the President of France sneaks off to visit his mistress. What do I do in Paris? For 20 years I have been an artiste, a painter. My specialité, in fact, the only thing I can actually do, is portraits of cats, like my acclaimed masterpiece, Fluffy on Her Pillow, number 4, or Kiki de Maman, Hélène de la Perzie, Untitled Abstract, number 17. Do not put me down for this. Tout le monde, everyone in Paris wants Pierre Vaurien to paint their cat. And there are beaucoup cats in Paris. If I do not make beaucoup d'argent, much money, it is because I am, how you say, a dreamer. Like most French people, I love le cinema, especially Jerry Lewis. For him, I am fool, crazy. But everything reminds me of a movie. In fact, I became a painter in the first place because of Gene Kelly.
This is Paris, and I'm an American who lives here. I'm a painter. All my life, that's all I've ever wanted to do. Brother, if you can't paint in Paris, you better give up and marry the boss's daughter.
Alors, I must confess that I was forced to take up art. Before that, I was a music hall entertainer. Yes, the nightclubs were where I had wanted to be since as a petit enfant, a little boy, I was taken to the Moulin Rouge. Très sexy. I became a song and dance man, following the wonderful example of my old friend Maurice.
Hey, la fête, un tout petit piton que je t'avais à ta tontelle.
From the Folies Bergères to the Lido to the Moulin Rouge, I was Maurice's chosen successor, a star on the biggest stages in France. Here I am, in my younger days, at the Folies Bergères, performing my most famous number.
I'll build a stairway to paradise with a new step every day. I'm going to get there at any price. Stand aside, I'm on my way. I've got the blues, and up above it's all fair. Shoes gone and carry me there. I'll build a stairway to paradise with a new step every day. With a new step every day.
All Paris was at my feet in those days. But my best friend was a sad little guy named Henri. I used to meet him at the Moulin Rouge. He claimed he was an artiste, but as a painter, Henri did not have a leg to stand on.
Can I drop you, Monsieur Le Trec?
There's one drink left, Hitler. I will finish it.
My girlfriend was a big-time singer, like me. Edith was always getting into some sort of trouble. Drinking, drugs, all that Judy Garland murdered. But mon dieu, she was terrific in the sack. In fact, she had so much fun in the sack, she expired at the age of 47. Quel talent! Quel dommage qu'elle est morte! I was a third husband, and I still wear our wedding ring in fond memoir of those 5 wonderful days.
After I lost Edith, I had the joy of making love with the great beauties of France, Catherine Deneuve and Anouk Aimée, at the same time!
Allez, on dort. Ça te gêne pas que je sois toute nue, non? Ça te gêne pas que je sois habillée, quand même?
I had everything. A beautiful Citroën deux chevaux, and even a nice little dog. Yes, a dog. I was at the top.
I was up there with Jean-Paul Sartre, André Malraux, President de Gaulle, even Ed Sullivan.
The diminutive French star, and of course, one of the all-time greats.
But then I developed a terrible case of stage fright, a real, how you say, phobia. My terror at facing an audience was like the attack on the Foreign Legion at Fort Zinderdorf, Beaugest, 1939. Whenever I did get up the nerve to perform on stage, my famous baritone voice, it was not the same. Critics said I had changed from Maurice Chevalier to Tiny Tim. As I slunk away in shame, all my friends deserted me, all except the cats. I began painting them with le bonheur de mon cœur, joy in my heart. And that leads us into our story, the story of art and love. and spring in Paris. American goddess, like that girl with the French name, Angelina Jolie. I am badly out of practice, but it never hurts to try.
Ah, my little darling, it is love at first sight, is it not? No? Do not come with me to the Casbah. We shall make beautiful music together right here. C'est l'amour. C'est toujours... c'est l'amour!
Let me see. How would Maurice do this? Pardonnez-moi, mademoiselle. Oh, excusez-moi, madame. I do not know your name, but I would bet it is Mimi. Yes, Mimi. Let me sing for you.
Are you mad?
Yes, I am mad.
Mad for you!
Mimi, you funny little good for nothing. Mimi, am I the guy? Mimi, you sunny little honey of a Mimi, I may be high. Mimi, you got me sad and dreamy. You could free me if you'd see me, Mimi. You know I'd like to have a little son of a Mimi Vaurien.
I don't know what Pepe Le Pew here is seeing in me, but here's what I'm seeing in him. I could call that gendarme across the street, but it looks like he's busy.
You have a license,
monsieur?
It is against the law for you to play your musical instrument.
The law?
What?
You say it's against the law?
Yes, unless you have a proper license.
What kind of license?
A license that permits the playing of any musical instrument in a public place for the purpose of commercial enterprise.
How do you know so much about city ordinances?
What sort of stupid question is that? Are you blind?
Yes.
Oh, I see. Yes, yes. Yes, of course. Well, you happen to be talking to a police officer. And because I expect to be transferred back to the detective division at any moment, I will let you off this time with just a warning.
Thank you, Monsieur Argent.
But you must get yourself a proper license.
First thing tomorrow.
Try to do something about your filthy monkey.
Do I need this? A week ago, my bargain flight to Paris on Air Zimbabwe took 12 hours to get here. Since then, I've spent every minute studying the great artists who painted in France. Picasso, Monet, Matisse, Cézanne, Van Gogh. I have no time to put up with some over-the-hill playboy. How do you do, monsieur? For your information, my name is not Mimi, it's Irma Hawkins. Dr. Irma Hawkins, licensed psychologist.
Vous êtes psychologue? But that is impossible, n'est-ce pas? I was admiring your advanced artistic technique. Pierre Vaurien. A booth of service. I happen to be a serious artist, like you. Perhaps I could give you some lessons here in Paris. You can make big money in America painting the cats, like I do. It would be a pussy riot. Regardez! Voulez-vous peindre avec moi ce soir?
I don't think so.
It's true that I'm also an artist.
Pepe, or Pierre.
I majored in art at the University of Colorado. I have a large body of work, and I've had several shows. But I wish I could sell more of my art. I came to Paris for more art studies.
Thanks, Pierre, but I've already signed up to take portrait classes with the famous Michael Siegel. I hope to learn so much someday I can quit my job. And frankly, I didn't come to Paris to make l'amour with a guy whose main contribution to Western art is Fluffy on her pillow.
Oh la la, you delightful creature, you make fun of Pierre. But I am known for my sophistication as a lover, especially for my brilliant pickup line, put some France in your pants. But anyway, je m'en fous, I care nothing for the scorn of the world. Avec moi, tout va bien.
I'm so happy, happy-go-lucky me. I just go my way, living every day. I don't worry, worrying don't agree. Winter, fall and spring, I just smile and sing. Things that bother you never bother me. I think everything's fine. Living in the sunlight, loving in the moonlight, having a glorious time. Haven't got a lot, I don't need a lot, coffee's only a dime. Living in the sunlight, loving in the moonlight, having a marvelous time. Just take it from me, I'm just as free as any dove. I do what I like, just when I like, and how I love it. I don't give a hoot, give my cares the boot, all the world is in rhyme. Living in the sunlight, loving in the moonlight, having a wonderful time. I bet what I like, get what I like, once in a while. But if she says no, I let her go and keep on smiling. I'm right here to stay when I'm old and gray. I'll be right in my prime. Kissing in the sunlight, loving in the moonlight, having a wonderful time.
Irma, I will prove to you that my knowledge of art goes beyond the pussycat.
When you have spare moments here in Paris, it would be my pleasure to introduce you to three women painters you will admire. Two are French, one is American.
Paris is a woman's town, after all. We even have a new woman mayor, Anne Hidalgo. So come discover Paris and her art, along with me. What have you got to lose, eh?
Well, Pierre, I guess it would be all right. You can reach me at the Mama Shelter Hotel on the Rue de Bagnolet in the 20th arrondissement.
109 Rue de Bagnolet, 20e, c'est ça. Je connais bien cet hôtel. Je te verrai là bientôt. Until then, au revoir.
Wait, Pierre, you forgot your baguettes.
By God. This is almost as inspiring as my all-time favorite film.
Play La Marseillaise. Play it.
Irma's hotel was so far off the beaten Parisian track that the metro has not stopped near there since 1929. The The hotel was convenient only to Père Lachaise Cemetery, where, aside from Jim Morrison, great artists including Modigliani, Delacroix, Daumier, and Pissarro are entombed. Even more remote was Monsieur Siegel's studio in Montreuil. It was like winning a trip to New York and staying in Far Rockaway. So, to be with Irma as much as possible, I volunteered at her art workshop. Monsieur Siegel was kind enough to supply a carton of my Gauloise.
The eye this way, yes. Then the whole face will look like it's yes. turning. Right now, this yes. part looks exactly. facing this way. So make this. No, it's good. And like this, right? It has to look like it's okay. going around. And the eyeball coming from here.
Yet there were times when just we two could meet to explore the museums of Paris, Le Centre Pompidou. Le Musée d'Orsay. And when Michel Siegel took Irma's class to the Louvre, I went along, despite the terror I held in my heart. You see, since I saw the movie version of a certain thriller book, I have been terrified of being in the Louvre. As we strolled under the sky of Paris, I gave Irma my advice on painting, and our friendship ripened.
Le dimanche pour aller danser, on mettait tous nos souliers dans le même panier. Et pour pas les abîmer, on allait au bal à pied.
I learned so much about Irma. Like the fact that, like me, she had a caniche, a French poodle, named Daisy. I told Irma that was enough to make her an honorary French woman. I began to fantasize about a future together.
So, Pierre, now that it's time for me to go home, where is my introduction to those three women role models you promised me?
Ah, but here is a surprise, ma chérie. You have already met these women in the museums. Yes, the Americana was Mary Cassatt. Not only was she a leading impressionist, but did you know her brother was the president of the Pennsylvania Railroad and built the Penn Station? Then there was Bertha Morisot. And Rosa Bonheur, who ended up near your hotel in Père Lachaise. Voilà! Trois femmes formidables!
Pierre, you have taught me so much about French art.
And with your help, as you can see, my paintings have gotten so much better. Maybe when I get back to California, I can even sell something for a change. There must be something I can do for you in return as a psychotherapist. Would you like to talk about your stage fright?
Mais certainement, I will go into therapy with you in hopes you can cure my paralyzing stage fright. Content as I am with my furry little niche in the art world, I would love to return to the music halls just to hear that applause and to feel that love again one more time.
We can fix your phobia right now. Pierre, your only problem is the fear of ridicule. Rather than worry over the changes that anxiety causes to your voice, you should own the changes. If you show confidence in your singing, no matter what it sounds like, the audience will accept you on your own terms.
Sacre bleu! That is magnifique! What you are saying is that in the years since I was laughed off the stage, society has changed for the better. Even if people will think I am, how you say, transgender, they will love me for it now and will want me only to be happily married to a nice French boy. I thank you for giving me the courage to try again. Irma, I am so grateful.
If the nightingales could sing like you, they'd sing much sweeter than they do, for you brought a new kind of love to me. If the Sandman brought me dreams of you, I'd want to sleep my whole life through, for you brought a new kind of love to me. I know that you're the queen, and I'm the slave, and yet you will understand that underneath it all, you're a maid, and I am only a man. I would work and slave the whole day through if I could hurry home to you, for you brought a new kind of love to me.
But what does this mean, Pierre? I'm ready to toss away everything, including my husband Victor, to make a new life in Paris with you.
As much as I love you, that would be wrong, mon petit chou. We each have greater things to do, missions in art and music we must place ahead of our selfish desire.
Hilda, I'm no good at being noble, but it doesn't take much to see that the problems of three little people don't amount to a hill of beans in this crazy world.
It doesn't take much to see that the problems of two little people don't amount to a hill of beans in this crazy world.
Inside of us, we both know you belong with Victor. You're part of his work, the thing that keeps him going. If that plane leaves the ground and you're not with him, you'll regret it. Maybe not today, maybe not tomorrow, but soon and for the rest of your life.
But what about us?
We'll always have Paris.
Well, that decides that. Talk about a dreamer. Obsessed with the damn movies. You have an incurable problem with being here now, being in the moment. Pierre, I could never live happily with you. So for us, it must be goodbye.
Yes, you really must leave me to my singing and my dreaming, mon amour. Alors.
Goodbye, Pierre, but let me say to you, in the only French I know, vaya con Dios.
Irma flew back to California, and we began emailing each other. So I soon found out that her art had become strongly influenced by my mentoring. Meanwhile, I booked the Lido for rehearsals, and in the empty hall with the hired orchestra, it went very well. Without an audience, I was back in my old form. No stage fright, a perfectly restored voice.
Elle avait de tout petits petons, Valentine, Valentine. Elle avait de tout petits tétons que je tâtais à ta tante. Tonton, tontaine, elle avait un tout petit menton. Valentine, Valentine, outre ses petits petons, ses petits tétons, son petit menton.
elle était frisée comme un mouton.
The news of my comeback after 20 years was such a big cultural event in France that the entire shows of the Folies Bergères and the Lido were relocated to the Opéra, the grand 1871 opera house where Parisian high society mingles. My old entourage, the manager, the agents, the PR people, everyone was watching and waiting. Et maintenant, mesdames et messieurs, dans son retour attendu il y a 20 ans, le maître légendaire Pierre Vaurien. Yes, thanks to Irma, I realized that for 20 years I was subconsciously resisting a magnificent destiny, channeling Edith. Between the two of us, we are going to be bigger than ever.
Connie!